fellow humans. Edelbrack Smith here, broadcasting from somewhere on terra firma, and today we're going to be reviewing Get Packed for Google's Stadia. Developed by Moonshine Studios and published by CoatSync, Get Packed is a single-screen co-op party puzzler in the vein of the fantastic Overcooked. Before we get into it, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel for reviews, news, and interesting takes on all things Stadia and cloud gaming. I've spent the last few days playing Get Packed, both solo and with friends. The game is at times hilarious, with some standout moments both scripted and spontaneous. But does that mean the game doesn't have any problems? Oh, it's got problems. Let's get into it. The game contains a campaign mode with 12 stages split between 4 levels, and those same 12 stages can be played with the campaign goals or in a special destruction mode, where your goal is simply to wreck shop. Additionally, the game contains a versus mode where up to 4 players split between 2 teams compete to pack the most value into their respective moving trucks. Sadly, this mode can't be played on the normal maps, instead being restricted to 3 special stages. I get why they did this, to make sure each map was fair to both sides, but it ends up being a bit too fair. The maps are just mirrored and it all feels a little boring. This takes some of the chaotic fun out of these stages, and being restricted to 3 maps drastically lowers the replay value for this mode. Me and Mrs. Smith spent several hours with the game, but probably only played the versus mode once for each stage. Having a full team of 4 probably would have made it a bit more interesting, but it was the weakest mode for sure. The objective of the game, at least if you're playing the campaign mode, is to pack as much stuff into a moving van as you can within the time limit. That's complicated by all manner of things, the most prominent being that everything is built out of balsa wood, flying apart at the slightest touch. And now that may sound like a negative, but it's actually the main source of chaotic fun in the game. Running into a laundry room and ripping the washer and dryer out of the wall, then running throughout the house with them bouncing off the walls, furniture, and other players is hilarious, and there's no doubt about it. Trying to maneuver a couch out of the house across the street only to smash it so hard into the inside of the moving van that it explodes never got old. Other obstacles are angry security guards, belligerent programmers angry that you're taking their foosball table, and some more interesting things that I don't want to spoil too much. The game is simple to control. The A button is jump, B is a boost reminiscent of Overcooked, though be careful using it as you can trip over debris or cause items you're holding to burst into splinters, and the value of the items that you break comes off of your score. You can grab items with your hands individually, L2 grabbing with your left hand and R2 being for your right. If you grab a single object with both and it's not too big, you can pack it into a smaller box that you can easily fit into the truck. You only get to do this every so often, and the cooldown is not per player, but for the entire group. Now that's about it for controls, aside from the Y button, which just causes the character to faceplant onto the floor for some reason. I can't figure out why this happens, or why the developers would add it, or why I should use it. If you can figure out how it's supposed to be utilized properly, drop a comment below. So, like any good puzzle game, the controls are dead simple. It's how you put them together that determines whether you get 3 stars or fired outright. You get money for the value of each item you pack, as well as special bonuses that appear if you pack the item they're asking for before the timer runs out. Each campaign stage has up to 3 stars, a hidden trophy, and various challenges to complete. Some of these challenges can get hard, and I'm pretty sure a few simply can't be beaten with a single person. I'm looking at packing the car in the second stage here, as well as a few others. The challenges are where the game starts to show signs of a lack of polish. I already mentioned that some of the challenges seem impossible without a group, and many of them are difficult to the point where you're going to need to retry the stage over and over to complete them. Now that's not a problem. Look at something like Super Meat Boy, probably my favorite platformer of all time. You die constantly in that game, but restarting a level is instantaneous. Even if it takes a while to complete the level and you die toward the end, it never feels like you've lost a lot of time and you're back into the action before you can get frustrated. You know, until the later nightmare levels. But let's take a level and Get Packed where you're trying to move a museum, but the security guard didn't get the memo. One of the challenges is to get 3 stars without the security guard seeing you once. That means if you're seen, you have to open the menu, restart the level. Easy enough. But then you have to wait for the level to reset, click through the opening dialogue again every single time, and then wait for the truck to slowly back up to the loading spot, all before you can even move. Now that may not seem like a lot, but when you're repeatedly retrying a level to complete a tough challenge, it can really ruin the fun after a while. Continuing with the frustrating parts of the game, the campaign isn't complete. What do I mean? I mean, once you complete level 4, you get a cutscene setting up level 5, but all the stages in level 5 are, quote, coming soon. When I first hit this, I was honestly furious. I thought that they had lied about the number of stages. So I backed out and checked the store, and nope. It says 12 stages, which is true. What it doesn't say is that the story isn't completely in the game yet. Luckily, with a game like this, the story really isn't a major reason to play, but it actually takes some interesting and fun turns that I didn't expect, all to lead to a cliffhanger. Hopefully level 5 is coming soon, but it makes me wonder if they wanted to get the game out for the Kinect, when perhaps it may have helped it to hold it back just a little bit longer. There were also a few bugs I encountered here and there, such as when the camera just completely bugged out on me when I accidentally locked myself in the moving van. Another time, during local co-op play, my right hand just stopped wanting to let go of objects. It would take 10 to 20 seconds after releasing the button before my character would drop whatever he was holding in that hand. I can't explain how frustrating that was, but it only happened once, and a restart of the game combined with unplugging and replugging my Stadia controller seemed to fix the issue. So do these problems ruin the game? Well, they definitely mean I'm not as excited as I was before I got my hands on it, but the game is still a lot of fun. The graphics have that Unity physics puzzle game look to them, if you know what I'm talking about. They're cute, but nothing really stands out, though there are some stages that are super creative and a treat to look at, with a few of them having some pretty cool gimmicks. Like the store that's having a Black Friday sale and every now and then a wave of shoppers will just rush the front door, or the haunted house where you need to vacuum up ghosts a la Luigi's Mansion before they possess and break valuables. If you are interested in this game just to play the campaign once and you aren't interested in getting all the stars or completing the challenges or playing co-op, then I'd probably wait for a pretty big sale as the campaign is pretty short, especially compared to its closest contemporary, Overcooked, which had closer to 30 levels, some of which were pretty out there gimmicks. If, however, you're the type of player who loves replaying stages until you get all the stars, find the trophy, complete the challenges, or if you want just a crazy fun party game to play locally or online, then at $19.99, the game is absolutely worth it. The chaotic nature of the game means that it can be a bit frustrating when playing alone, but when playing with others, every stupid mistake or unexpected event becomes a just hilarious moment where you'll be laughing about it throughout the rest of the night. I do wish the game had some more specific interactions between players, where coordination was emphasized, and I think the destruction mode isn't fun for more than a few matches due to the objects not feeling very weighty or satisfying to destroy them when that's all you're focusing on. Plus, you still have to wait for the moving van to back up every single time for some reason. Still, I'm happy with my purchase. I've played the game with Mrs. Smith as well as online through its matchmaking system. When I queued, I couldn't get a full group, but the game had just come out and getting matchmaking on Stadia overall can be a bit hit or miss right now. Still, I did manage to find another player and we had a blast. If you need a game to play with friends during these trying times of social distancing, Get Packed is a great pick and a win for Stadia. It could have been better, but I imagine that we'll see Moonshine Studios continue to support and improve on the game in the coming months, and I for one am excited to see what they produce. Oh, that's too bad. Looks like the interference is kicking up again, so I'll have to end this video. Have you picked up Get Packed? What do you think of the game so far? If you haven't picked it up, are you planning to? Say hi on Twitter if you want to get a game going. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you again soon. Edelbrack Smith, signing out.